in a relationship, you don't need to suppress things. Some people do is like they keep patience. They say, I have a very great understanding. So if the child or your grandson or say for your mother-in-law does something wrong and you are like, last year bhi aapne aisa kiya tha. Or yeah, last time, last Diwali bhi you did things like that. Look, who is gonna remember the things you are suppressing it somewhere in your heart that he has done wrong with me, and after so long you are expressing it, the time has gone. Imagine somebody is going to Mahatma Gandhi and saying that in your childhood you have stolen things, you have eaten non-veg, and now you are teaching us like that. Look, that time he was Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi and today he is Mahatma Gandhi. So there is a big difference, there is a big gap gone between. He has gone into a transformation state, he has undergone many circumstances, he has evolved. So now if you go and tell that person, it's very wrong actually. If you want to develop intimate relationship, you need to express every feeling of yours to your partner or your relatives so that they understand what things affect you and what things they shouldn't do so that they develop an intimate relationship with you also. Look, man is a social animal. He needs his loved one, his relatives, everyone. So what things applies to you applies to them also. They too want a happy life and happy relationship. I'll say, to form a magical relationship, you need to have understanding. Imagine a person, say for example, mentally retarded or say mati manda person, he goes around and break things and throw things. What are you gonna do? You are gonna go and fight with him? You are gonna go quarrel with him? No, you are gonna understand that he is not mentally fit, and if I go and fight with him, even he can attack me. So it's better to understand him emotionally that he is not well. Similarly, you understand for every and each one of your relationship that he is not mentally fit, so he is reacting like this. So what are you gonna do is you will not expect things from him, and you'll do what can I give to your relationship. For example, say for child, you need to be strict with that particular child. If you retrospectively think, who are you most attached to today is the person who has been most strict to you in childhood. Think over it, what I am talking to you right now, because say for example, your mom is strict, so today you are attached to your mom the most, and your dad was not strict in the in your childhood. Actually, your dad was acting like a part-time dad, and actually he was like trying to form an impressive image in front of you because he had to spend a less time with you, and your mom was strict because she wanted a permanent changes in your life so that it gets better. And for teens, you say they have a childlike ego, a very cute ego. They sometimes won't talk to you for a week and so what can you do to this, or what can you give to this relationship is a non-verbal talk. If they are not talking to you, go around and just tap on their back or just smile to them. Look, they are not gonna come back and fight with you or harm you. They have a ego who, if you see in their eyes, they are dying to talk with you. They are in that longing for love from you. So for teens, you can give is a non-verbal talk, or give a love to them. They desire, just let go or look out that ego of theirs to you. Then to the adults, I already mentioned that look at their emotion, why they are reacting like that. And if you understand why they are reacting, they are not peace at one with oneself, or they consider them that they are not in the state to talk to you. So stop expecting from them and give what you can give to them. And for older sins, or for the old people, look, with the age, the ability to take things diminishes. So if a old person says you that lower down the music, so you don't react to him ke abhi to main ghar aaya hu, abhi ghar pe bhi awaaz nahi karu to kaise karu. So it's like their nerves are not that good enough to take that loud music, so they are talking to you like this. Or sometimes it happens that they are gonna say you something, and after 2 or 3 hours they are coming back to you and saying you the same thing.
Look, they are not mad. They have actually forgotten what they have told you. And the third most important thing is longing for love in old age is more than longing for love in the childhood or in teens, because they have nobody other than you and you are busy with your life. So give some time to them, and otherwise you know what can be done more better way. Then coming to the fourth point, that is avoid clashes. Fifth is adjustment everywhere. I have already told you about the van wala example. Then sixth one is intimate relationship.
So to develop a magical relationship, these are the do's and don'ts of your life. To just down the things for today, first is count your blessing. Then second and third activity, do it together. Take a hour time for yourself and write down name of two persons or three persons who are affecting you mentally, physically, whatever, you are hating them. So to heal the relationship with them, write the things you are grateful about them or qualities you like about them. Then call them, try to solve your relationship, say them sorry or things like that, and do with the second person and do with the third person also. Then after you do this healing, then the third thing is be grateful to the person who has magically caused changes in your life. So be grateful to them. Read aloud whatever you have written for them in your list and see difference what you feel. Do you feel happy after being grateful, or are they happy? Are they converted from fishes to the dolphins? So take an hour and do this activity together so that you develop so much great energy that it helps you to complete your goal and make magic thing work for you. And this task is really a beautiful task. This is a life-changing task, and this is gonna help you or boost your energy in a greater degree, in an intimate degree. So do this task very dedicatedly, and after this, don't forget, why before you sleep, hold your magic rock, recall whole of your day and choose one of the best thing happen with you and say, be grateful to it and say thank you, thank you and thank you. So I hope this helps you. So meet you tomorrow. Bye bye. Have a nice day and have a very, very different day from every day. So take time for yourself and do this activity. You're gonna enjoy this activity. So bye bye.